Welcome back everybody into the third week FTMO recap, and we're going to have a look at what happened this week and thoughts for the next, for the old challenge, and of course for the next week upcoming. As you already know, today during the recap it's mostly based on also the psychology part, the what I think I'm improving, where I still think that I'm really, really behind, and what I did better than last week, what I did worse than last week, etc., etc., and the plans for the next one. So, as you can see, I like to remind you where we are in my journey towards being a full-time trader. We are here. We are at the first step. There's nothing bad about it. We're just the first approach to the markets live after almost 1 year of backtesting, of understanding the fundamentals, and with fundamentals, I mean the foundation of trading, the studying psychology, reading about psychology, about technicals, and etc., etc. So this one is our first 10K challenge with a little investment that is going to have two different outcomes. One is most likely, with most of the luck in the last week, I will be able to pass it straight away and go into the verification, and then eventually pass the whole challenge. Second is the one that I think it will be the most probable, but not because I'm thinking about, so I'm not trying to think, okay, no, you're going to lose. No, it's not about that, but it's because it's most likely, and it's it will be the most welcoming as well. So this whole challenge is not being made and done to be passed. That's why I'm saying that. It's made to learn, and this thing will eventually happen even if I pass it. And I will do a deep analysis of the trades and the trading system, looking for improvements, looking for necessary changes, and nothing will be safe. No take profit partials, no lot size, no win rate, risk to reward, no setups, no pairs, nothing is safe. Because if I fail, or I don't get to the objective, there's something that needs to be fixed, because the objective is 10% per month, and it's something that should be quite reachable if I'm a good trader. So this is the whole very nice first step, the first wall, which will be the hardest to be build. In order to have already a framework, a template, an understanding, and know-how on how to build the second wall, and then merging the accounts, and the full house will become later on. Let's start with all history. So up to date, what is the results of the challenge? As you can see, we are down 2% on the overall. Remember that the maximum that we can lose is 1K, and what is the target profit is 1K, which is 10% and minus 10%. So we are still 12% away from the challenge, but remember, it doesn't matter. And especially remember that to qualify for the free repeat or the extension, so 14 days more. For the free repeat, I need to close the challenge with at least €1 in profit. To have 14 days more with the same challenge, I need to close like with 500, so 5% more in profit. And that's it. So the goal is to at least close in profit so that I can have a free repeat, which will be what I just showed you, that in my journey, I will be able to continue for free. Just repeating another challenge, but for free instead of paying another small fee. So this It hasn't been a very nice week, but we're going to go step by step. We are down 2%, which is not the worst that we have been down, because I think like the first week at the end we were down 2.5, yeah, 2.4%. Then last week we recovered almost everything. And we were only down 0.26%, it was almost break even. And this week, the third week, was quite a week, because as you can see, and this is what is the okay. We went from up 2.5% on Monday, up 2.5, up, so making 2.5, so up 2.1, then coming down towards 1%, then minus 1.8, then basically break even, minus 0.5. To yesterday, we do come to minus 2%. So it has been up and down, and this is also clearly shown in the metrics that FTMO provides. As you can see, this is based on the number of trades, but as you can see, this one was the start of the week. I'm almost 100% sure. I think it was like these. Probably this one was the first week, second week, third week starting very good, and then making his way down very, very aggressively. Looks like we still haven't found a flat because we have broken the last lower low. So maybe we will go to minus 300 to jump back up. I'm kidding, we're going to see it about it. But let's start with the notes of last week coming into this one. So what was my goals for this week were to keep consistent lot size, possibly increase. I was very, very optimistic, still not happening because I'm still very down. And don't be afraid to take losses and take trades after losses. There's a one day, which is, I guess, this one, where I took 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 9 losses and one win and one break even. And I'm not going to say that all these trades losses were good, but they were not even bad. I already talked about it. Quite some unlucky trades here and there. And for example, what was like only the spread that took me out. Look, one pip and then going into my TP, and then gold, same, one pip and then going to my TP. So that was a rough day, but I was not afraid to take losses and take trades after losses. Even yesterday, I was down with three losses already. And I kept doing New York. I was down three losses. I got a break even, still unlucky, and then got a loss. And unlucky because, as you can see, 28 pips instead of 30. But I'm not afraid. So these two have been done. Take the opportunity your guts tell you. And let me go first on this one. Never have a modified position manually. I was able to to control much, much better. But in a couple of occasions, especially I know when yesterday this win, as you can see, the first one was a partial taken automatically. this 0.15 I took at 20 pips manually, instead of letting it go to 0.25 at 30 pips. So it was a minor touch, but I still touch my trade. These, for example, this full win, I was not watching the chart at all, so I just let it go, and that was good. So I'm not, never ever failed, but at least I reduced a lot about it. Usually before I used to enter the trade, place everything, and then open the modify position manually just to be sure. That was not good. Okay, take all the opportunities you guys tell you. This ended up in quite a massacre. And this is, as I showed you here, we're going to see. Okay, this one was the first one. That meant that I should have taken, that I should take everything that I wanted. So 1, 2, 3. Yeah, here. And I already explained, I already talked about this much more specifically in the video of the 30th of March, but this ended up taking all the opportunities that I felt like, and this isn't ever, ever good, because what now I added here is take all the trending opportunities, because I ended up taking a lot of trades which were not good trades as per my setup. Some were, and were unlucky, but some were not. So a lot were not, were small volume, just the first breakout sign, and that was not good. So quite okay with this. Keeping consistent is absolutely fine now. Taking trades, if I find that it's a good opportunity, I do. And this one, quite, take all the opportunities, quite hit me in the butt. And this one, much, much better, but still not 100% nailed. Let's have a look at the notes from last week. So we start with the notes from the 28th of March, and first trade, full lot size, aggressive entry, stop loss place, and partial STP setup. Felt the urge to modify position to reduce it while it was not moving. I forced myself not to touch it, and then it went to my TP. Was even 45 pips instead of 30. This one was the first sign of, okay, I'm good. I'm fighting. I understand that I have this urge to modify, but I know where it comes from. I really understand it, and I can just remove my hand from the mouse, and that's a problem solved. 29th of March. Very nice entries, unlucky that the price retraced my stop loss at break-even before going to 20 pips. Flawless. Here, unlucky that they didn't take the partials for like at 1 or 2 pips. I like, this is a confirmation of, emotional confirmation of good having 10 pips stop loss at break-even, because he can... I don't incur in losses, so it is higher win rate, even if it's smaller sizes. Not missing entries, I was very good, because I was taking entries, and this one was second day of the week, so taking all the opportunities. I made a mistake, I took partials at 25 pips on gold instead of patiently waiting for 30 pips. Exactly this one, I remember it, and was on the 29, was... And okay, was this one, was, no, where it was, gold trade, okay. As you can see here, was a very nice entry. This would end up going to like 300 pips. When I saw here the price bouncing, reaching 30 pips, but not triggering, then I took manually here at, it was 25 pips. And instead, I should have waited. This is a mistake that I already did. And... It's quite a mistake, because as you can see, here we go, directly to 30 pips. And yeah, this one was a high, very aggressive entry, but it was okay, I don't know. And emotionally, it was a mistake to take the partials at 25 pips, and I find a way to justify myself, so it was not good. New York Open, this is the day I remember of the a few losses, not the worst day ever. I made too many mistakes, 2-4, okay, I remember this one. I was going left and right on TradingView, gold, GJ, gold, GJ. There were a lot of fundamental reasons, news, so I was very, very, very confused, because okay, on GJ, the yen should go down, but it's going up, but gold is going up, so GJ should go down. If gold is going up, yen should go down. So I was very, very confused. One loss was very, very unlucky. This one taken out by the spread, and then immediately to TP. My second loss was at the trend resuming. So let's see. First loss was here, which was, as you can see, ended up going exactly to my TP. And second loss was below here, when I saw, okay, retrace and go down. I don't know if I'm going to take this quite kind of trades anymore. Maybe I will wait for price to break down this level, especially on currency, not on metal, because I'm finding myself very, very stuck in a lot of losses like this, because the price is not aggressively, it's not always validating that the price will break below here. And it's not gold, it's much different. And these losses prevented me to take nice entries on gold, clean and backed up by fundamentals, because looking at GJ, I was not focusing on gold, which is better during New York time. I have to stop focus, blah, blah, blah. Counter trend trading after changing my mind from pre-planned possible opportunity, 3 losses. Emotionally unstable due to missed opportunities, and first loss being unlucky. Okay, let me just give you a second. Okay, I'm back, I took a quick break. And this is a very important, very, very important topic, which is which we're going to touch in the later notes. So we're going to leave it here. 30 of March, very volatile on gold, took one entry on GJ, got very lucky, close to 20 pips. Wait and recovery took partials 15. So yes, this one almost went to 20, retraced, didn't took me out at break even, and I placed the partials at 15 pips. It barely touched it, and then it went to my, as you can see, almost to 20 pips. Then it went back, almost break even, and 15 pips right before going back to break even. So at least some partials were taken, and this is this is the crazy losses day. So I don't know, I don't even know. Yeah, this one was not even journaled properly. Wrong timing. Exactly, this one was my fault. I took this rushed entry while then left the charts. This one could have been a further bet, much better confirmation. What I did was taking the further entry, break, retest, and also the very next candle gave me confirmation. For me, this one was not a bad trade. This one might have been. Here is a break and retest of this PSA, which gave me quite unlucky entry, but as you can see, maybe also this level was too strong for just taking the re-entry, but it was broken. Maybe if the retest was here, then it would have ended up in a good trade. And let's see, more patience to avoid the loss, blah blah blah. Exactly, this one is the overall judgment of the day, yes, I got quite a few unlucky shots, like this one being taken out for a few pips, but then going back to my TP, this one being a very bad trade, the price was not trending, this one being a bad trade, rushed trade, exactly, this is what I was thinking of. Okay, sometimes it works, aggressive break and retest, but with these, all these price action is not guaranteed. There's nothing guaranteed. Maybe, I don't know about percentages, but sometimes it's good, sometimes it's bad, depending on the volume. And I took one entry. Another entry at this small candle. And this is why I say, and then as you can see, I missed the proper one. And I missed this one, which I was highlighting. And this is say, and the journal of the 30. Entering when price is not in trend, I'm trying to predict when and where it will start. That was referred to this and this trade. Taking sells when the price is going up, not even engulfing, and that was it. I missed the sniper entry, which I was chatting up, hourly time frame, trend line, and I entered live at this candle close, which was very, very aggressive. And as you can see, it went to my first partial. This one was good because, as you can see, is okay. I already have further rejections. I have the price starting to trend in my direction, breakdown. Even here would have been a nice, very aggressive but understandable entry. And this one, like if I took it half a second before, half a second later, I would be good, because with the spread of one pip, I would be absolutely good. So I should have waited probably for the candle to close and then take the entry. Was just a little bit unlucky. Last trade, very, very unlucky. I already showed you one for half a pip. I understood this one was a price that I put a buy stop during the morning, during the start of the New York, after seeing all these rejections. I said, okay, if the price goes above, it will go very impulsively. I removed it, of course, during this time to avoid one spike to go down. When I saw this very candle aggressive during New York Stock Exchange, I placed a buy stop here, and just for one pip, then it went to my TP. Here, I took, for example, another loss, trying to validate myself the same thing. So, okay, now this one is a huge rejection, the same PSA as before. It will be the start of the very next trend. Okay, but this is not I'm taking a break or retest in trend. I'm taking a break or retest or rejection to hope that the price will go in trend immediately. And that one, as you can see, if I entered at the candle close, I would be in partials taken. So that changes everything. Look at this candle. Enter very, very low. Rushed after the candle closes like this, and then that was it. And yes, as you can see, if I waited for the candle to close, that would be absolutely good trade, because the price was already starting a trend, not as you can see, was already showing us strength, not like here. So we go to the 31st of March. It was very, very nice. One win, one loss, breakout loss, and one win. So I was very, very chill, and it was a very good day. Nothing to journal. Only thing was that I took these partials where I should have not, but it was a nice day. Nothing. I felt good, because after such a day, the day before, I felt good to be able to be clear, have a clear mind and take nice treats. And we come towards the last day of the week, which is yesterday, first day of the month, and was -1%, which is not bad, but okay. First entry, first loss, pre-London, in trend, yes, but low volume. I'm starting to think that pre-London is not always good, but I miss an entry. This one is for later. I miss one opportunity during pre-London with clear direction volume, and I was not on the chart. I mean, I saw it, I should have been. I was in a break, waiting for London to open, and miss one opportunity, and it's not good. Afterwards, this missed entry, I don't know if it was, was it, yeah, it was in London, okay, during London, okay. So then I placed a pending order that I already showed you, and which was missed by one pip, but my mistake was that I should have been entering manually. Then I took a loss afterwards, trying to catch the retest, which was not a retest, to go up again, and this and goes with the, as you can see, missed entry, missed one opportunity, and as you can see, this is the main goal of this weekly recap, to read this. My daily performance is highly affected by the first trade and or the first one or two missed clear opportunities. It has been clear to me that when this happens, I go in a very subtle FOMO that makes me look energetically for further trades in the same bias as sometimes you encounter them. But as you can see, I miss this entry. It's quite a feel energetic. Okay, yeah, okay. Let me wait for breakout test and enter. I want a breakout test. It's not like I wait for further confirmation with a nice candle close above this previous PSA. No, any candle is fine because I want it to go to my TP. And also, I start thinking very obsessively about, okay, I start to count, okay, from my entry, now you see it would be 10 pips, you see now it would be 12 pips, but now I'm focusing on the trade that I lost, the opportunity that I lost. For example, on gold, I missed this opportunity, which should have been my entry. I missed it, and when I was here, looking for a further entry, I was, okay, you see now it would be like 20 pips would be already a break even. Ah, you see now it would be 30 pips, partial staken. And then this candle flips in half a second and I take a very rushed entry. I'm looking forward an entry and that's not good. I'm not waiting for the setup to come at me. And this is because I have either a first trade loss or one or two missed clear opportunities that I know I should have taken. Okay, now how do we deal with it? First of all, when I miss an opportunity, I need to, I need to understand why I miss some opportunities. Sometimes it's because I'm second guessing, sometimes it's because I'm stepping away from the charts. And sometimes it's because, okay, it's 8:30, London Open is in 30 minutes, and I feel a relief of saying, okay, let me step away and go back in during London. Sometimes it might be good to avoid taking bad entries, but especially when I knew that price was trending with some volume, like on gold, it was in a trend, I should have not escaped from the chart. I should have stayed. And sometimes it's something that happens quite a bit, not a lot as before, but quite a bit. Sometimes I am second guessing. When I'm in a trade, I always step away from the chat because I want to avoid modifying it partially, and that's it. I have to enter manually, not putting a buy limit after a candle breakout, because this one candle breakout at a PSA was something that I was looking for very, very hard. And I'm talking about this entry. I should have just taken manually. Yes, then it will end up going to 10 pips and then break even. It's fine. But at least I would have not taken a further entry, rushed a further entry. I would have just been unlucky that it was just 10 pips. But at least, okay, I took my opportunity and I go out without a loss. That would be absolutely perfect. I have to test my analysis and entry manually. And it's not like, okay, I entry now, but I mean, 10 pips would be here. So, why do I want a clean candle and then here push like here? No, it doesn't happen. It's not realistic. And if one or two missed opportunities for whatever reason, I need to step out from the charts. My head is filled with thoughts about the missed trades, how many pips it will go, and how many pips it will already be, therefore kind of forcing me into losing rush trades. I start thinking, okay, you see, now this one would have been at break even, now this one would be here, blah, 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 blah. It's bad. It's very bad. So it's better if, for example, for here, for gold, I say, okay, I realize that I'm thinking only about this trade. That should have been the trade, my trade for the day, for the London session. If I took it or didn't take it, it's the same. It's like I took it, because it's a matter of opportunities and situation. Okay, this one was my opportunity. I missed, that's it. I'll go back to New York fresh. Because if I take and look avidly for trades, when I'm thinking about the first trade, I will miss something, I will just react very weirdly. Especially, yes, if this one was a win, that I would be great. I said, okay, yeah, I missed this one, but I managed to take a breakery test, yes. The point is that when I take a loss, the loss feels very bad, feels much worse, because I said, okay, you see, I missed a winning trade and I took a losing trade. Compared to, I missed a winning trade, but okay, I took a breakery test and it went good. So it's fine, because as you can see, I was able to catch another trade. It's very, very result dependent, and it's not good for my emotions, because then I go into New York with already 2-3 losses, and then sometimes I might make mistakes. If I miss a couple of opportunities, that's it. That were the trades for my session. I took them or not, does not matter. This was the situation I should be in. Then I'll say, this was during my session. It's not like something happened during Asian that I was not trading. These were during my time. Why I missed them? What can I do to take them in the future? This is what I need. This is what I need on psychological part. Is my main goal that we go towards here, towards the next week goals. And technically this is something that is more of a thought for the after first FTMO, for the full analysis. Let me just copy and paste this. But okay, now that I'm having some sort of sample size, what am I good at in live trades? I know I'm not trading 100% right, so what am I good at? Am I a good breakout trader? How many break every test I catch and how many I lose? Am I good at catching this breakout, or am I better to catching a pullback and go back? Breakout instead of like trying to cut breakout, as you can see, this time is gonna win a very nice breakout. Breakout failed, not a real trade, or better to catch a bounce from a PSA and in continuation. This will be the situation that I will ask myself, especially after the full FTMO, because I need to understand if I have to change the setup and with only maybe trying to understand better. Am I better at finding the end of pullbacks at specific PSAs and understanding the price action confirming the bounce towards the main direction? For example, here the very good trade on gold. So as you can see, this is a breakery test, very good. This is a breakery test, bad. And this is a pullback, end of the pullback, understanding where the price can bounce, validating this trade and entering two candles above, after. What am I good at? What has the higher percentage for me to trade? And we're going to see, because breakouts, I feel like they are sort of 50-50, sometimes even less, because sometimes, as you can see, breakout, I get stopped out, and breakery test, I get stopped out, breakery test, I go to, I think, to break even, this one as well. So I think this one goes good. No entry, but was in the good direction. And this is the one of GJ. Breakery test. So I feel like I am good at breakouts, but it has not the same, doesn't have a high win rate. Of course, when it goes good, it goes 1-3. Most of the times, this is something that I found, even on gold. If it is good, it goes to 1-3. If it is bad, of course, it goes immediately against me. So this is something that we'll have to learn, because it will be analyzed in the risk to reward. Because if it is really that like 80-90% of the breakouts, winning breakouts, go to 1-3, then I have to stop taking partials and take the full TP at 1-3. Otherwise, those wins will not be enough to cover the losses. Because if I take 100% at loss at 15 pips, I should take 100% win at 45. 1-3 risk to reward, otherwise it will not fit, it will not work out. So it's something that I have to understand. 50% when it is winning, how often does it go to 45 pips? I have to understand it. I'm not doing it while trading, I will do it after the FTMO challenge is over. Am I better at finding where? Am I good at understanding when and where the price can likely have impulsive and strong moves? Like for example, the one that I showed you here, which was unlucky, but I understood that here above this level, the price could just go. And as you can see, it went just after taking me out. And can I change something in my partials full TP that will adjust win rate and risk the reward? Okay, this is something that I don't know if it's due to losing a lot now recently, but okay. How many times, and let me show you here, that something that I am doing, how many times the trade goes to 10 pips with a 10 pips, 10 pips stop loss? How many times it goes to 20 pips? How many times it goes to 30 pips on goal? So for example, I want to understand, okay, but if I take at 10 pips, I take the full position out. What is the win rate that I need? What is the not the win rate? What is the win rate that I can have? Because let's start from one thing, the metrics. Metrics of this week show something interesting. Okay, very very messy. The times, London Open, New York Open, not good. Afterwards, some nice. Negative doing London Open, and this doesn't really matter, but of course I have a negative risk to reward. As for now, you can see the average profit is not enough, is not covering the losses, and of course the expectancy is negative. But what, look at this win rate, 51.5%. So I am still having more winning trades, which means also partials and break even with a slight advantage. So that's why the average is average win is less, but I'm still having 50% of win rate. It's not the end of the world. So my question is, if I had a full TP at 10 pips on GJ, 100% of the position at 10 pips. What, this is part of the analysis, what percentage of trades that I took would be either winning trades instead of losing, or would be winning instead of just break even? And as you can see, compared to some of my other setups that I will see, a 80% win rate will deal the same profits as like a 65% if I took at 15 pips versus a 55% if I took 2-to-1. So that doesn't mean that means, okay, how many trades on GJ would go to 20 pips? If it is at least 55%, then it's better than taking the full 10, even if this one is 80% win rate. But this is something that I will have to check. It's the same on goal. If I take 1-to-1 full TP on goal, this one, if it is an 80% win rate, it's basically the same as 70% or 20 pips, or in the middle is like 51-52% on 30 pips. But how many times does it go to 30 pips? Does it go to 30 pips 50% of the time? Do I have some that win rate? I don't know. So these are all considerations that I will do afterwards, after the FTMO, taking a couple of days of full analysis. And that's it. Okay, as you can see, these are the notes for the next week, for the upcoming week, and I have to enter manually. Okay, exactly. Why did I miss them? How many breakaway tests I catch? Percentage. This is also possibly due to the fact that this one is good. Let's see, maybe possibly increase to have further chance on the challenge. This one is good. Ok, Okay. Trending opportunities, never ever modify the position. The point is, the point is the following, that, what is the point? I already forgot the point. Yes. I don't remember. Okay. But I think the points were already talked about a lot overall. So let me copy and paste this so that before the start of the fourth week, and these are the last 2 days, then I will be able to read them and to understand them. And yes. Okay, the point is that maybe my breakery tests are having such a bad win rate because I'm not taking the right breakery tests during the right times. Maybe if I just select those breakery tests during high volume on the chart, then I will be able to possibly have a better win rate. But the point is that sometimes I think that the volume is there, is coming, closing above, and then just goes against me. Or make retest and just goes against me. Not this one. This one is no volume, no movement. Make a retest and goes against me. And I mean, goes against me for a bit, because afterwards it goes into my direction. Yes, here, but it's very choppy, it's not clear. Here is much clearer, here is much clearer, and I'm unlucky. For example, here, 30 or 20 pips. Full TP, that's it, bam. How many times, this one, 15 pips, boom, full TP. This one, 15 pips, full TP. This is what really I have to understand. Because yes, then afterwards, some days I will miss out because 15 pips, full TP here, and then I miss this. Okay. But for example, here, 30 pips and then goes to 45. Okay. So is it really worth it, or is it? How many times the price goes to 30 pips, then it goes to 45? This is some very difficult calculation that I have to do. For example, here, it would have gone to 30 pips and then straight down to my entry. So I don't know about this. But this is it for today and for this week. See you on Monday.